Fáilte, and welcome to this Traces Unit training video. Today we're going to be going through the creation of a DOCUM certificate. On the top right hand corner of the screen you can see I'm in the training environment today. This will be very similar to the live site. And I'd also like to point out that we are signed in as a French economic operator, as this is the only profile that is available to us in the training site. So today we are signed in as the LMS Place of Departure France. So anything that I do put in today will be under a French economic operator. While in the live site, while you're doing these, you'll be signed in as an Irish operator. So anything that I'm putting in today is France, you'll be putting in as Ireland. Okay, so you'll see on this gray bar here, we've got documents, dashboard, actors, publications, and help. Today we're going to be clicking on documents, and then we're going to be going down here and clicking on a DOCUM. So when you click on DOCUM, you will be brought to this screen here, which is Search Commercial Documents. If you click on the blue search button here, you'll be brought a list of all DOCUMs that have been created so far on the system. As this is the training site, this is all that has been created so far. But if you wanted to search for one specifically, if you knew the number specifically, you can just... I'm just going to use this one as an example here today. If you knew this number, for example, hit search, it'll just bring up the number you were looking for then as well. But for today's example, we are going to be creating a new commercial document. So when we select new commercial document, we are brought to the screen here, so we have to select our commodity. Depending on your commodity, it will be depending on the commodity code. For today's example, we are doing animal byproducts, so it'll be 05, be 0511. We're going to click onto 99 and we're going to click on animal byproducts, derived products not intended for human consumption. This is the one we're picking today. Once again, it'll be depending on your commodity. It will depend on your commodity code then as well. So we're going to select this one here and then we're going to hit the green button, done. And we are brought to our part one of our DOCUM. It's a new commercial document. So as you can see here, there are certain boxes that have red asterisks beside them. Anything with a red asterisk is mandatory and must be filled in. So I'm just going to scroll down here and let you see anything there with a red asterisk has to be filled in. So our first box here is I.1, which is the consignor. So for today, we are signed in, like what I said, as the French economic operator LMS. You'll be an Irish operator, so you'll just putting in your Irish consignor here. So we're going to click in advanced, and we put it in our country, which is France, and then we're going to click on LMS. So as you can see, LMS is here. We've got three different matches for LMS place of departure. These are because of the activity types that are associated with it. So there is an exporter activity, an importer activity, and is an APB processing plant activity. So this is the one we're going to be selecting. It is important that you choose the correct activity type. So make sure you have got the APB processing activity and that it's valid as well. So we've selected that there. If we click on these three dots down the bottom, we can see our activity, just to make sure, is there APB processing plant. And we have our ID here, and then we've got our address down the bottom here as well. Section I.2 is our certificate reference number. We will be given that at the end if we save as a draft, save as new, or we sign our declaration. We'll be given a reference number for that. So we'll come back to that in a bit. Our local reference number in I.2A is just if it's a reference number you want for yourself. We can put in anything here. So we're just going to put in test. You don't need to fill that in. It's non-mandatory. Box I.3 and I.4, which is our central competent authority and our local competent authority, are currently empty as well. These will automatically be filled in when we fill in our place of loading. So we will go back to those later. So the next box we're going to fill in is I.5, which is the consignee. Now, unfortunately, on the training site, Germany is the only country we could find that has a valid APB processing plant in it as well. For the consignee, in your case, you'll be putting in Northern Ireland. It'll be the exact same thing as well. So we're just gonna, on this case, on the training site, we're gonna go into Germany. And then we can search, but we're gonna go for an advanced search, and we can actually also search the activity type. So we want an APB processing plant here. So we can just search here in Germany in our processing plant. And so this one comes up here. It's a process APB processing plant, and we have a valid status, and activity type is correct as well. So we're going to select that there. Once again, you can see it, this is a processing plant and activity. It's got its ID, and then we've got the address down the bottom here then as well. So once we have box I.5 filled in, we're going to scroll down. I.6, which is a registered trader, is a non-mandatory box. So we can just go through this. I.8, which is the country of origin, and then the I.9, which is the region of origin. These boxes will be selected automatically based on the information we put into the place of origin here, the I.12 box. I.10 and I.11 will be the same. The information will be automatically uploaded by what we put into I.13. So for I.12, which is our place of origin, will be the same as the procedure we have for box 1, which is going to be our consignee. So we're just going to select advanced. And remember, in your case, this is going to be Ireland. Here it's France. I'm just going to put in LMS again. And then we're going to scroll down to the appropriate LMS plant. So we've got our APB processing plant, we've got our activity here, and we've got a valid status on the activity then as well. So we're just going to select that there. I.13, which is our place of destination, this is going to be the same as I.5. This will be Northern Ireland for you. We're just going to put in Germany here, and we're going to select our processing plant again, which is this one here. We got our valid status, we got our APB processing plant, and we can just hit select, and this is our place of destination. The next box we're going to look at here is the I.14 box, which is the place of loading, and this will be the same as I.12 and I.1. So we're just going to click on advanced, and go back to France again, and click on our LMS, apologies, we'll click on LMS here, and we're going to click on our APB processing plant, and with our valid activity again. Our next box we're going to look at now is our date and time of departure. This is another mandatory box. We do recommend you have these filled out 48 hours before the departure leaves as well. So for today's example, we are going to say it's going out on the 22nd. If we just select our calendar here, we can select our date, and then we can select a time here as well. I would say caution you as well, there's a clock symbol here on the right hand side of this box. If you do click it, I'm just going to show you now as well, if you do click it, it brings you to today's date and time as well. So we don't recommend you click that. So we're just going to click back on this and change it to the 22nd, and we can keep this at, let's say, 2 o'clock. You can also just scroll up and down and pick an appropriate time on these menus here, or you can type it in though as well. So date and time of arrival is not a mandatory box. You don't need to fill that in. I.16, which is our means of transport on the training site, for some reason, it's not selectable, but on the live site, it will be a mandatory box. So you must select the proper means of transport in this on the live site. Your transport organizer is a non-mandatory box we have here. So the next mandatory one will be our transporter. Now the transporter is mandatory and must be a valid activity as well. So we're just gonna put in France here. You'll be putting in Ireland, and we're gonna search. So you would search for your approved transporter here, or your transporter of choice, and they must have a valid transporter activity type. So for this one, for example, we have the transporter activity type. It's at a valid status. So we're just going to select this one here. This will be depending on which transporter you have or the transporter that you use, but they must be at a valid status, a transporter status, when you are using them. The next box here is our links box. So say, for example, you had a DOCOM certificate that was replaced. So this was a new certificate that was replacing an old one. The old one would be linked here in this box as well, which you'd be able to select into it. We don't have that today in the training environment, but this is where if this was a replacement certificate, the old certificate would show up here in the links box. The next box we're going to look at is I.21, which is our product temperature. This will depend on your product, of course. It is a mandatory box. So I am just going to put in chilled into here. This will depend on your commodity as well. I.23, which is our container number and seal number. Our container number and seal number, they're non-mandatory boxes. We don't have to fill these in. The seal number is only if it had an official factory seal, you would put that in there. But this is a non-mandatory box though anyway. Our next box here is I.25, certified as. Select the correct option for you for the intended use of the consignment. The options here that are displayed are depending on the consignment code that you have put in at the start as well. So for today's example, I'm just going to put in other, but each of these will depend on what you are moving. I.26, I.27, and I.28. You are not going to be really using these at all going exporting up the north. And these are just if you were transiting through a third country. So if it's gone from Ireland to a third country, say Great Britain, and then back into Northern Ireland, you would use this one. If they were going through a member state, so say it was going to from Ireland to France and then Northern Ireland again, you would select France here. And then I.28 is export, so if it was going to Northern Ireland and then being exported, then after that would be these boxes. You'd use the I.28, the export box, and you'd put in the relevant information there. You will not be really using these. It is very, very unlikely they'll come up. But that is just a very quick run through of what each of these boxes is for. So the next section we're going to look at here is the identification of our commodities. So I.31, which is our commodity box. We can add a new commodity, we can modify, or we can change the CN codes that we've chosen at the start. So if you've put in the wrong CN code or the wrong commodity at the beginning of the certificate, you can change it here. Now they've got the mandatory signs here, but you only change if you need to change or if you put in the wrong thing. Here we can clear identification, so we can clear that. We can add back our identifications there as well. Then the bottom here, we have got our default weight unit, so we can put everything into kg if we want. Then the quantity of the unit, so we've got pieces and units here, and then the package type as well. We can change here on the package type. These are non-mandatory though as well. We don't have to go through those today, but it's just if you need to. If you had a package type that you were constantly using over and over again, you could change it to a default zone, the default package type, so everything would be in this particular type. So the next box we're going to look at here is our commodity box. As you can see, anything here with a red asterisk beside it must be filled in. It's all mandatory. So the first thing we're going to go here is choose our species, which is going to be mammal. The nature of the commodity, this will depend on your commodity as well. And then the training site, we've got a huge amount of options here. I don't think there's going to be as many on the live site. So just select the one that is appropriate to you. For today's example, I'm just going to choose animal. Then a treatment type, once again, this will all be dependent on the nature of your commodity as well, and the treatment type used for it as well. I'm just going to put in other here. Our manufacturing plant, so that is my LMS place. In your case, it'll be your Irish place of business. So we are just going to make sure we pick the right activity type and make sure it's got the valid status again. So we're just going to select our APB processing plant. Now your batch number, this can be anything at all. It can be numbers, it can be letters, or if you don't have a batch number, it can simply just be NA. If you need to be. So we're just going to say for a batch number, we're going to put in a random number there. Our next box then is package count. Once again, this will be a number of packages you have. So we're just going to say we've got 10. And to the right-hand side unit, you must select the correct unit of your packages then as well. Once again, these will be depending on... how you package these then as well. So I am just going to put down package for this example today. You'll just select the right option for you there. And then our net weight, I'm just going to say is, we'll just select our correct unit as well on the right-hand side. So select unit, we're just putting kilograms. I think there's more options on the live side as well when you are using the units here then as well. So we've got kilograms or tons. We're just going to put in kilograms today. And we'll say it's 1,000 kilograms. So when you've completed your commodity section, you're happy enough with it, you can save here as a draft if there was anything else you needed to add in. If you weren't sure, for example, the time of departure, we'll say, you could save it as a draft. And then when you do get that information updated, you can go back to this then as well and update the appropriate information. I just want to show you something here. If we say, for example, we'll take out our date and time of departure. And we can just save here as a draft. And we've created our draft and we're at the draft stage up here. So I'm just going to copy and paste this into our search box. So when you've got something saved at a draft and you have your number then saved as well, you can simply just search for it here on our search screen. And when we first came into the Docom section of traces, and we can just select it here. And then here's our draft. And then say, for example, yeah, if you're waiting for your date and time of departure, we can simply just add that in then again. Like we said, it was 1400. So after we put in our date and time of departure, the only other thing you need to do then is fill in part two. So part two is our declaration. And the only part to sign here is our signature down the bottom. So we are going to say that we are in France. So this will be done. So you will say Ireland. So this is like done at France. You will then put in your business here. So we are LMS today. This will be your place of business. And then we are going to say the 20th of the 12th, 2023, which is the date today. And that is all you need to fill in part two. Just before I sign the declaration, I just want to show you what happens if you do get an error. So say, for example, we don't have our consigner in. We're just going to clear that out. And I go to sign the declaration. I'll immediately get this error message here saying the consigner must not be empty. So say if I was struggling to look for where the error was at some point in the form. If I click here, consigner must not be empty, and click on the error message, it will bring me up to the box that's wrong, and there'll be a red box around it, and it'll flash yellow as well. So we can it's very intuitive in terms of showing you where the errors are. And let you fix those errors then as well. So we're just going to put France back in here. And our APB processing plant too. So I'm just going to have to reselect my competent authority here when I've put in my consigner again. And now that I'm happy that everything on the form is filled in correctly, I can sign my declaration. And we have our DOCUM successfully created. And declaration signed. And if you can see up here as well, we got our certificate reference number. Now we've got a new reference number after we've saved as a draft. We've got a signed number now as well. So if we wanted to look for that again, our signed DOCUM, we would simply copy and paste in our number here. And there we have, we're at the status of signed. So after this step, the DOCUM can not be amended anymore. It is possible to copy as new and generate a completely new document or replace this document as well, which you'll be get like the initial document will then be at a status of replace. And this is where it would enter into the links part of the form if you were to replace the document. So in our actions here, see, we can print our PDF, we can copy as new, or we can replace. So if you wanted a hard copy of the form, you would simply, you can print your PDF. If you were doing the same consignment a couple of times a week or every week, and you're using the same, it was the same consignee every week, and only the amount of commodities that you're sending up or the specific commodity type might change, you can copy as new, and 95% of the form will be here when we copy as new. As you can see here, we've clicked on copy as new, and this is going to bring us up a brand new document again. Pretty much everything is in there that we've filled in before, bar the date and time of departure, which we can just fill in again. So say this is going out on the, we'll put in the 28th, and we'll put in 2 o'clock again. So this is one thing you'll need to fill in again. Everything else here is filled out the exact same way we did as the last form. The only thing that will show up is there's a few more options here. From there's a couple of non-manager options that have popped up. If we select this hide optional columns, it'll just be the exact same commodities that we've put in from before. If you need to change that as well really, really quickly, we could put in maybe it's 12 package accounts and this goes up to 1200 kilograms. It's very, very handy to do that as well and saves you a lot of time. And then we can just go to part two very, very quickly. Put in France, and we'll just update this to the 28th. And we'll sign our declaration. And you can see we've just successfully created a brand new document just by copying as new and only changing a couple of little bits around that we need to change. So we can paste and search for this again. And then that's our brand new certificate then too. The other option then we have is replace. So if there was anything after this was signed that you noticed was wrong, you can replace the certificate and start again. So if we just select replace here, so this is going to it'll tell us at the top, it's going to replace and cancel this document here. All our information is going to be here if you wanted to change whatever was wrong. And then in the links box that I talked about earlier, it'll just give you the link of the document that it is replacing. This concludes our training video today. I hope it was helpful, and thank you very much for listening.